Oscar nominations are out. We have two Kababayans on the list. We'll talk about that and talk to Rufio. He's in the house as Kababayan LA starts right now. The Bosco family. If you haven't, what planet are you on? Today on the show, we're going to talk to not one, but two of them. Ngayon pong araw yan sa Kababayan LA, we're going to be opening our phone lines so you can call and ask them with your own questions. What's going on? What are they up to? We'll find out later on in the show. Also today, kaninang umaga pa, 5:30 ng umaga, ewan ko kung sino mga gising around that time, inannounced po ang Oscar nominations. And we're very proud to have two Kababayans who made it on the list. And we're going to be talking about that today also on the show. Stanley Mirador, ang ating pong kababayan, cover that event for us this morning, and he's going to be joining us today via phone. Pero bago ang lahat, it's a Tuesday, makibalita naman tayo sa ating mga kababayan sa Pilipinas. Hello, May Valdez. Welcome to Kababayan LA. Good morning to you.
Hi, Janelle. Not a really good morning for most Filipinos, but it's good to, again, be back here on Kababayan LA.
All right, not a good morning because everyone is talking about the bus blast in Makati. Anong nangyari?
So this happened yesterday, just before about 2 p.m. Ang driver na ang pangalan, ironically, ay Maximo Peligro. Na peligro rin ang bus na ito. It was driving along EDSA. And the bombing happened before the bus reached EDSA Corner Buendia. That's near the north gate of Forbes, which is one of the posh villages here in Manila. So it was placed now under the seat of in the middle of a passenger, and as of this morning ang balita namin 13 injuries, and of course kumuha siya ng limang buhay.
Okay,
bombing na to.
Lima ang patay, and the question is, who is behind this attack? Terrorist ba, or is it a ploy to destabilize the Aquino government?
Correct, those are the debates going on right now. It's by against bato na isa batong paninira sa gobyerno natin, isa batong panggugulo dahil sa dami din ng mga iba pang problema like the carjacking, kaliwat kanan ng mga problema na ginamit sa gobyerno, o talagang terrorist attack. And they were saying right now kasi the Makati Police Chief, CC Superintendent Froilan Bonifacio, they were saying they have yet to determine the kind of bomb that was used, no, but it shattered the windows of the air-conditioned bus. Talaga namang maraming nagulat. It was horrible traffic the whole day of yesterday because of that.
And not only that, a lot of our Kababayans in the Philippines, they rely on public transportation. And because of what happened to this bus, meron bang fear?
Everyone's afraid.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, yesterday, one of my employees, dinispatch ko siya for a meeting. Supposedly, uuwi siyang nakabus. Janelle, nag-taxi.
Okay.
Kahit na 40 pesos na ngayon, nag-taxi siya sa takot niya sa kanyang buhay.
Exactly. Speaking about taxi cabs, merong recalibration na nangyayari ngayon. What can you tell us about that?
Awa ng Diyos, tayo daw ay magkakaroon na ng mga resibo pag tayo ay nag-taxi, no? Meron ng recalibration. Nangyari to sa mga, alam ko, sa mga plate numbers pa lang na 1 and 6. Meron ng mga taxis ngayon na hindi na sila pwede ngayon masyado mangdaya dahil syempre, meron na tayong resibo at 40 pesos na ang flag down rate.
But you know what?
Sorry, yun ang initial na babayaran mo, and then 350 every after.
Wow, I remember when I left the Philippines, 25 pesos ang flag down rate. Yes, that
ngayon,
was
tough. Ngayon, wala na ang 25 pesos. Pinako na yan sa bintana.
Oh,
40 pesos na ngayon.
Grabe, 7 years ago. But you know what? It's about time that we did that because everywhere else around the world, nag-i-issue talaga ng resibo ang mga taxi drivers. Okay, all right. Mm-hmm. Now, let's talk about some other stuff that's happening in the Philippines. Good news naman tayo.
Good news naman. Okay,
tell us about the new Pinay Pride.
Of course, 17-year-old Filipina, 5'9", Miss Danica Magpantay, na anak ni Lala Flores, isa rin dating supermodel title holder, ay nanalo sa napaka-prestigyosong 2011 Supermodel of the World.
Okay, what was she doing?
Atayo pa lang ang,
What was she doing before that? Was she modeling na rin sa Philippines?
Yes, but she's actually a fine art student sa UP.
Oh, wow,
so, matalino rin ang ating representative. At siya lang naman ang first Filipina to win the Supermodel of the World. At siya rin ang second Asian, kasi ang unang nanalo na Asian country ay South Korea. So, we are extremely elated. Siyempre, we need good news. No? Parang Venus na din ito na moment na good news, tapos medyo may bad news.
Alright, congratulations, Danica Magpantay. Yes. Meanwhile, okay, good news, bad news. Another bad news, Baron Geisler, what's happening to him?
The very sensational kid na child star dati ngayon, nako, kilabot ng mga babae dahil a lot of people are complaining, a lot of artists are complaining na sila ay medyo may pambabastos lagi involved si Baron. So, nauna na dyan yung anak ni Yayo Aguila na si Patricia Martinez, si Julia Clarete, nagreklamo, si Yasmin Gerdy, and very recently, nako, medyo cougar ang dating, Cherry Pie Picache, nagreklamo rin against Baron. And from what I know, he will be papasok na siya sa rehab dahil sa kanyang alcoholism.
Okay, what does he do particularly to the girls? Does he just grope them, grab them? What happens?
You said it, and there's even, Yasmin Curdy even complained that he was doing semi-sexual acts in front of the girl. Kaya naman talagang lahat kaming mga babae, hindi kami makapaniwala sa inaano, minamanifest na ugali na ganito ni Baron, who's pretty young
nakakaloka.
For a teenager na medyo ganyan.
Pero,
siya kasama.
Okay, ang kanya bang reason is because he's always drunk? What, is he an alcoholic? Now, that's why he's going to rehab?
Yes, he's a major alcoholic. At ito pa, ang kanyang reaction to getting into rehab, he's very excited, Janelle, and he's looking forward to it.
To entering rehab, aba. Okay, alright.
Para niya party din ang rehab.
Nga. Baka gagawin, he plans to make a party out of it. Meanwhile, thank you so much for sharing those stories with us. And obviously, abangan natin ang mga developments sa mga balitang yan. But for now, thank you and be safe there in Manila.
Yes, thank you very much.
That was May Valdez, our correspondent in Manila. Meanwhile, when we return on the show, Balitang Hollywood naman tayo. Dahil nandito tayo sa Los Angeles, land of the stars. We're going to be talking about the Oscar nominations when we return. Don't go away.
You poke, cut, squint, and swear, but you still can't thread that needle.
Hi, Anthony Sullivan here for the 1 second needle. The needle with the built-in threader. Instead of taking the thread to the needle, you take the needle to the thread.